Well, the Celtic Explorer is Ireland's largest national research vessel. It's owned by the Marine Institute, and it's 65 metres long, and it operates over 300 days a year undertaking research in Irish waters. It arrived in 2003 and has been very busy ever since it arrived. The vessel is unique, first of all, for fisheries type work, because it's island property. So the vessel is called a silent research vessel. So it's designed to a particular noise curve called the ICES 209 curve, which is set by ICES, which is the International Council for the Exploration of the Seas. So when the vessel was designed, it's designed with electric propulsion, which is the quietest way to propel a ship. And every part of the ship is designed to be as quiet as possible. So it means you're not altering the fish's behavior in the water. And also all your equipment works a lot better because it's coming from a quieter platform. So the background noise is a lot less. So that's one of the key unique features of the vessel. It also has dynamic positioning, which is becoming more common nowadays, but that's used when you deploy equipment such as the ROV to remain on station above the area it's deployed and to move around in a controlled manner, allowing the ROV to complete its work. The Explorer also has a lot of deep water capability. We have a CTD system, which is conductivity, temperature and depth, which is a unit that's dropped down through the water column to look at the temperature, salinity of the ocean, as well as taking samples of that water that you see. So we can do that work down to about 5,500 meters. And we're also able to use coring equipment and other types of grabs and drop cameras to look at the seabed using some of the winches on board the ship. The bulk of the work on the Explorer is fishery stock assessment. So we do a stock assessment on our pelagic and our demersal fish species, which go to help set the national quotas for these, funded under European Maritime Fisheries Fund. So we spend about 90 days a year doing pelagic surveys, which is looking at the fish that are in the water column. So we use acoustic equipment for that. So we essentially use echo sounders. We can map where the fish are in the water column, and we can multiply it out and look at the size of the stock. And then we do occasional trawling on those to see what's in the shoals that we're viewing with the echo sounders. Then we do about 80 days a year on trawling surveys for bottom dwelling fish, such as cod and monkfish. So basically we do a set number of trawls every day for that period, and we count the fish that are recovered, we age them, and we use it to give a profile of the stock that's in the area. We also use the ship for seabed mapping, do a lot of deep water seabed mapping. We have equipment on board that can map down to 8,000 metres water depth, and we use that equipment, multi-beam equipment, to map Irish water. So we spend about a month a year doing that type of work. We also do oceanographic work, where we go out and we look at the properties of the ocean, and basically that's becoming more and more important as climate change is having a huge impact on the ocean. The vessel is then made available to the academic community to use for their research. So they apply under a ship time fund to use the vessel and our ROV Holland 1. So about 90 days a year are spent on that type of work. So we have different institutions such as UCD or UCC or NUIG. We'll use the vessel and the ROV, as well as the vessel on its own, to go out and look at different environments, looking for new species, both in geological work using the ROV. People, in fact, don't see the vessel in port a lot because it spends most of its time at sea, actually. So it spends up to 320 days a year at sea performing research. So it's actually allowed a sea change in effort since it arrived in 2003, because previously we had the Celtic Voyager, which was doing about 200 and something days a year with about 5 scientists on board. And suddenly we're doing 300 plus days a year with the Explorer, with up to 20 scientists on board. So, and it also, the capability of the Explorer allows it to do much more complex work than the Celtic Voyager would do. So we're looking at much heavier equipment that can go much deeper, that can do a lot more. So I think in a nutshell, it has really just expanded the capability of marine research in Ireland enormously since its arrival.